Okay, so now we're going to get into scatter plots. Going back into that and trying to find our line of best fit, and we can do that with a calculator. First of all, let's fill in this first little part here of our notes. A scatter plot is a graph of a set of data pairs. It's just relating two things, so it's showing a relation between two things. The data has a blank blank if the y increases as the x increases. So that means we're going to have a positive. Correlation. If the y decreases as x increases, we will have a negative. Correlation. And the data will have no correlation if the points show no obvious pattern. So describe the correlation shown by each scatter plot. You might pause and just take a second and see if you can figure these out real quick and then come back. This one has no correlation. This one has, this is y's are decreasing, y's are going down the y-axis as we go up the x-axis. So that's a negative correlation. Here, our y's are getting bigger as our x's get bigger, which is a positive correlation. You should have received a little cutout, little piece of paper, about half sheet, that has all of these instructions on for using your calculator to find the line of best fit or your slope-intercept line for a scatter plot. This needs to be glued into your journal, and you need to reference this, not ask, what do I do after this? What do I do now? You need to follow the directions here. Okay, so use this and open up your journals and use these notes in order to help you find the line of best fit. We're going to use those instructions in order to create this graph. So I'm going to have you pause the video for a minute, work on this, just drawing out your graph, labeling your axes and what they actually represent. Giving me a scale and then putting your plots on here, okay? Then you need to answer these questions. Then come back and we'll go over it. Okay. So we should have here visitors is your y-axis, temperature is going to be your x-axis. Usually, you know, your I don't have a little menu on here. Anyway, inputs usually go first in a t-chart, and outputs or your y-values are your second the second thing in your t-chart. You need to draw a line of best fit for these data, which is probably going to go along here. Remember, line of best fit is where you have about the same amount of points above your line as you do below. This would be a good scale to use. Then you're going to go through and use the instructions that were given to you to use your calculator to find the equation for your line of best fit. Let's see if I can get this to move. So what does your line of best fit tell you about the relationship between the temperature and the number of visitors at the beach? That as your temperature increases, the number of visitors increases as well. That means we have a positive correlation. And then if you'll get your calculators, pause the video, get your calculators, and we'll go through the steps and put this in on your calculator.